Crestor is used well along with a proper diet to help lower bad cholesterol and fats, such as LDL, triglycerides, and raise good cholesterol, HDL, in the blood. It belongs to a group of drugs known as statins. It works by reducing the amount of cholesterol made by the liver. Lowering bad cholesterol and triglycerides and raising good cholesterol decreases the risk of heart disease and helps to prevent strokes and heart attacks. In addition to eating a proper diet such as low cholesterol, low fat diet, other lifestyle changes that may help this medication work better include exercising, losing weight if you're overweight, and stopping smoking. Talk with your doctor for more details. Indications: hyperlipidemia and mixed dyslipidemia, pediatric patients with familial hypercholesterolemia, hypertriglyceridemia, primary dyslipoproteinemia, adult patients with homozygous familial hypercholesterolemia, slowing of the progression of atherosclerosis, primary prevention of cardiovascular disease. How to use? General dose information. The dose range of Crestor in adults is 5 to 40 mg orally once daily. The usual starting dose is 10 to 20 mg once daily. The usual starting dose in adult patients with homozygous familial hypercholesterolemia is 20 mg once daily. The maximum Crestor dose of 40 mg should be used only for those patients who have not achieved their LDL-C goal utilizing the 20 mg dose. Crestor can be administered as a single dose at any time of day, with or without food. The tablet should be swallowed well. When initiating Crestor therapy or switching from another HMD choreductase inhibitor therapy, the appropriate Crestor starting dose should first be utilized and only then titrated according to the patient's response and individualized goal of therapy. After initiation or upon titration of Crestor, lipid levels should be analyzed within 2 to 4 weeks and the dosage adjusted accordingly. Pediatric dosing. In heterozygous family hypercholesterolemia, the recommended dose range is 5 to 10 mg orally once daily in patients 8 to less than 10 years of age and 5 to 20 mg orally once daily in patients 10 to 17 years of age. In homozygous familial hypercholesterolemia, the recommended dose is 20 mg orally once daily in patients 7 to 17 years of age. Dosing in Asian patients. In Asian patients, consider initiation of Crestor therapy with 5 mg once daily due to increased rosuvastatin plasma concentrations. The increased systemic exposure should be taken into consideration when treating Asian patients not adequately controlled at doses up to 20 mg per day. Use with concomitant therapy. Patients taking cyclosporine. The dose of Crestor should not exceed 5 mg once daily. Patients taking gemfibrozil. Avoid concomitant use of Crestor with gemfibrozil. If concomitant use cannot be avoided, initiate Crestor at 5 mg once daily. The dose of Crestor should not exceed 10 mg once daily. Patients taking tazanavir and ritonavir, lopinavir and ritonavir, or sempervir. Initiate Crestor therapy with 5 mg once daily. The dose of Crestor should not exceed 10 mg once daily. Dosing in patients with severe renal impairment. For patients with severe renal impairment not on hemodialysis, dosing of Crestor should be started at 5 mg once daily and not exceed 10 mg once daily. Contraindications. Crestor is contraindicated in the following conditions. Patients with a known hypersensitivity to any component of this product. Hypersensitivity reactions including rash, pruritus, urticaria, and tardive edema have been reported with Crestor. Patients with active liver disease, which may include unexplained persistent elevations of hepatic transaminase levels. Pregnancy. Lactation. Warnings. Crestor can harm an unborn baby or cause birth defects. Do not use rosuvastatin if you are pregnant. Before taking Crestor, tell a doctor if you have ever had liver or kidney disease, diabetes or a thyroid disorder, if you are of Chinese descent or if you drink more than 2 alcoholic beverages daily. In rare cases, Crestor can cause conditions that result in the breakdown of skeletal muscle tissue, leading to a kidney failure. Call your doctor right away if you have unexplained muscle pain, tiredness or weakness, especially if you also have fever, unusual tiredness and dark cold urine. You should not use rosuvastatin if you have liver disease or if you are breastfeeding a baby. Avoid eating foods that are high in fat or cholesterol. Crestor will not be as effective in lowering your cholesterol if you do not follow a cholesterol-lowering diet plan. Side effects. The most common side effects may include headache, muscle aches, abdominal pain, weakness and nausea. Memory loss and confusion have also been reported with statins, including Crestor.